Namaste, my friends. Welcome. Thank you so much for joining me today. For today's yin practice, we're going to focus on relieving low back pain. And for this practice, if you happen to have yoga blocks and a blanket, please go ahead and grab it. If you don't have a yoga block, just grab a couple of nice thick blankets or thick pillows. So we want it to be at least about 5 or 6 inches thickness. And grab whatever props you need, and I will meet you on your mat. We'll start our practice with a really beautiful supported bridge pose. And for the supported bridge pose, I always suggest one, if not two blocks. You can have the blocks right next to each other and go for the lowest height. So you don't necessarily have to go high. If you only have one block, that's fine. Your options are taking a blanket and just kind of put it in on top of your block. And if you don't have a blanket, that's fine too. These are just different options. And initially, we want to just go ahead and lay down on our backs. If you have two blocks, you can put the two blocks next to each other. Put your blanket on top of your blocks. This gives you a nice little cushion for your bum. And then eventually, you want to lay down and lift the hips up. And as you lift the hips up, you want to slide your structure underneath your hips. So we come into a supported bridge pose. For this, I suggest that we start slow. So you don't go so high initially. You can eventually lift the height up a little bit more if you like to. But just initially, just start with a low height. And make sure that the blocks are under your hips, in other words, under your pelvis, instead of your low back. So just kind of play with it, make sure that the kidneys are not sitting on the blocks. The hips, the blocks are supporting your hips, and then you can turn your palms up. And I suggest that you do, for the bridge pose, you don't put a pillow under your head. Just let your head rest, because sometimes if you put a pillow under our head, we kind of flatten our neck out. So let there be a bridge underneath your neck as well. And let the arms rest right next to you. Just close your eyes for a moment. Take a nice deep breath in, exhale it out. Let go of anything that happened this week. And even if you have plans for the weekend, let go of anything that is about to happen this weekend. Just see if you can feel your body as the sensation that it is. It's kind of a cloud of sensation. Just do a little scan, check in your toes and the bottom of your feet, your ankles and your calves, your knees, your thighs, your hips, your low back and belly, your upper back and chest, back of your shoulders and elbows, forearms and wrists, back of your hands, the palms of your hands. Notice any tingling, any sensation in any body part. Feel the back of your neck, your throat, back of your head, and then your entire head. Feel your entire head. Your entire head. Notice your breath. Notice your natural inhalation, natural exhalation. Then notice if you can drop your awareness to your heart. It's almost like your awareness is in your head. Notice if you can just actually drop it to your heart. So notice your heart. Notice that space around the heart, the physical heart and the spiritual heart. Notice any sensations. Maybe even noticing the pulsation in the heartbeats. Excuse me. And then gently see if you want to extend your left leg straight. Notice how the sensations change as you extend the left leg straight. See if you like to extend the left leg straight. Notice if that transfers the sensation a little bit more to the low back. Put the left foot flat on the floor and extend the right leg straight. And notice what's happening on this side. And then put the right foot flat on the floor. And then see if you want to let the knees open wide to the side, so that the bottom of your feet come together. You're in this kind of a supine butterfly pose, except that your hips are lifted. Take a nice deep breath in. Let it go, open your mouth, sigh it out. Notice how the sensation just moves from one location to the other. Breathe into whatever sensation you're feeling. And exhale, let it go. And then gently begin to lift your knees back up towards the ceiling. Put your feet flat on the floor once again. With one inhalation, lift the hips up, slide the blocks or the structure from underneath to the side. And then windshield wipe your knees side to side. So let your knees drop over to the left. And then take your knees up towards the sky and let them drop over to the right. And do this a couple more times. Nice deep breaths in and exhale. Inhale and exhale. And next time your knees are up to the center, hold here. Take your right leg all the way up towards the ceiling. Place your right foot on top of your right ankle on top of the left. So this might be a really good place for most of us to stay. If you like a little bit more, you can take one of your blocks and put your left foot on top of that block. And then do the same thing. So figure four with one foot on top of the left, on top of the block. Stay here for just a moment. Notice the sensations that right hip. The next phase would be to bring that left foot off the block or off the ground completely. And see how that feels. Maybe now you're getting a little bit deeper into that hip. And then I'm gonna ask you to take both hands to one hand, your left hand to the inside of the right ankle, your right hand to the inside of the right knee. And gently begin to press that right knee open. So you're not doing anything else except that just the guiding that right knee. You'll feel the sensation in that right hip increase a little bit. Take a nice deep breath in. Exhale it out. And then with your left hand,
take that and put it on top of your right foot, and then gently begin to lift that right foot up towards the sky. So you're gonna feel that left shoulder coming up the ground, that's okay. Excuse me. And then now take that right leg all the way across your body. So your left hand is still holding onto the outside edge of that right foot. Take it all the way across your body. And you're gonna let that left knee drop down to the floor. If this feels good, you can stay here. Maybe some of you can take your right hand to your left toes. So you come into this pose called cat pulling its own tail. So your right hand is holding the outside edge of your right foot. Your right foot is on the floor. Your left hand is holding on to your right hand is holding on to your left toes. Let me say that again. Left hand to the right foot, right hand to the left toes. And your gaze is up towards the sky or ceiling, wherever you are. And then you close your eyes. Take a nice deep breath in. If you feel like you're struggling to get your right, left toes, just let them go. Just have the intention of the right fingertips towards your left toes, but you don't have to grab. Make sure that you're not struggling at all. And then wherever you are, gently release both legs. Bring that right knee to your chest. Interlace your fingers around the right shin. Let that left knee stay to the left. So keep that left knee in butterfly pose. Right knee comes to your chest. And then interlace the fingers and compress that right hand. Nice deep breath here. Exhale out. And put the right foot flat on the floor. Or maybe you like to try that right foot on top of your block. Bring the left knee to your chest. Take the left ankle on top of the right ankle. So your right foot is either on the floor or on a block, entirely up to you. And just pause here for a moment and notice what's happening in this left hip. If and when you're ready, you can pick up the right foot off the ground or off your block and draw it to your chest. But don't interlace the fingers yet. You're gonna take that left hand on the inside of the left thigh, right hand on the inside of the left ankle, and gently begin to press both away from your shoulders. So now you're gonna feel a little bit more sensation in that left hip. Pause here for a moment. Make sure the shoulders are staying soft. Take some nice deep breaths here. Exhale it out. You can rock a little bit side to side if that feels good, or you can stay still. And then for our next phase, you can bring that right hand to the outside of the left foot. And see if you can take that left foot up towards the sky. So the right shoulder is going to initially lift up. That's okay. Now see if you want to take the left leg all the way across your body. And then maybe you just want to pause here and just go into that nice twist. Maybe you'd like to see if your left fingertips can find your right toes. And if they don't, that's perfectly fine. Don't feel like you have to grab it. You can just kind of have that intention of reaching the fingertips towards the toes. So just so you're clear, right hand is to the outside of the left foot. Left fingertips may or may not reach your right toes. Cat pulling its own tail. And then close your eyes. Your gaze is up towards the ceiling, or you can even take your gaze over to the left shoulder. Pause here for a moment. Take a nice deep breath in. Exhale it out. Remember, the beauty of these yin poses is that we don't really try and get our bodies into a pose. Instead, we kind of work so that the pose can work for our body. So we kind of discover what is this pose doing for me. So it's really for us to get into our bodies instead of putting our bodies into a pose. Very, very introspective, a little bit, a lot different from our regular vinyasa flows. And then gently begin to release both legs. Bring that left knee to your chest, please. Interlace the fingers around the shin now. As you compress that knee closer to your chest, let the right knee go out to the right. So your butterfly on the right side and the left knee is coming to your chest. Take a nice deep breath here. Exhale it out. Bring the right knee to your chest. Rock a little bit side to side. Take a nice deep breath in. And then you can rock and roll up and down. This is really a nice massage for the spine. Just kind of rock and roll up and down. Nice and easy. And sit up eventually. We're all gonna sit up tall. And then here, I'm gonna ask you to just sit tall, cross the right ankle in front of the left ankle. Hands on top of your knees and begin to walk your fingertips in front of you. So this is maybe good enough for you. Maybe if you have your blocks, maybe you can take your blocks and just have your hands on top of your blocks, or maybe come down on your elbows. And if that's the case, you can stay here, or you can even put a couple of blocks or blankets on top of one another and have your arms rest. Or maybe you're a little bit more flexible and you can bring the elbows down to the floor. So different options, different choices for every different body on different days. Now, wherever you are though, let your head drop. Let the chin come to your chest, close your eyes. We're gonna stay here for 1 full minute, starting now. And I will always mind the time for you. So all you need to do is just breathe. Commit to stay in the pose and just breathe. Feel that nice release in your low back. Maybe you even feel a little bit of opening in the hips. Let the shoulders down your back. Usually I ask you to lift the chest up so that the spine is long, but in this yin poses, you can actually round the back a little bit and just drop the head forward. And then gently press yourself all the way back up. And then all you're gonna do is just cross the other ankle in front. Your hands are initially resting on top of your kneecaps. Inhale, and as you exhale, either hands on the floor, hands on the blocks, hands on two blocks, forearms down on the blocks, or forearms down on the floor. Your body, your choice. Let the head drop. Bring the chin to your chest. 1 minute. Part of the reason our low back gets really tired if we've been super busy is the adrenal glands rest on top of the kidneys. And if the adrenal glands are overworking because of us overworking or being stressed out, one of the symptoms is this kind of a low back ache. So we really want to just allow the adrenals, send some loving thoughts on to the adrenal glands, let them relax, let them, just allow them to just take a break. You can even mentally say to adrenal glands, plans, you keep me moving throughout my days. You can rest. Just go rest. Gently begin to press yourself back up once again. Bring in your knees to your chest. Put your feet flat on the floor and then lift your hips up, and you're going to take your blocks and sit in Malasana. So I really suggest that you actually sit on a block. If you don't have a block, again, you can just pile up blankets or throw pillows or something so that you sit here. We're going to sit here for a good 2 to 3 minutes. So I want you to, we have already started counting, so get really comfortable. You're either sitting on your block, or even a little stool would really be handy, or even blankets or block or pillows. Your hands can rest comfortably on top of your knees. Palms are open, close your eyes. Now I'm gonna ask you to lift the chest up. So try not rounding your back here. As you lift the heart up, close your eyes, let the back of your neck, the extension of your spine, let that be long as well. Let the chin drop down to your chest slightly. And then as you close your eyes, can you let kind of like water just, or warm oil washing over your face? So feel as if the warm oil can take away all the wrinkles, all the squinting, all the tension from your forehead, the corners of your eyes, the cheeks, the jaws, maybe even let your lips part slightly. Your tongue is heavy. I'm just going to feel that sensation of warm water or warm oil just dripping down your face and taking away with it any tension in the face. That tension in the face fades away. Can you begin to notice where you may be holding more tension? Is it the shoulders or the back? Where else can I release? Just 5% more. It doesn't have to be 100%. Can I release something, maybe 2% more? Maybe you're squinting or squishing your toes. Maybe just kind of relax the toes or relax the fingertips or the hands. Maybe your belly. Maybe you're holding the belly and can you let the belly be just soft? And can I release 5% more this next 1 minute? Is there anything else I can let go of? You may notice that you can breathe a little easier. Your eyes open, please. Bring your feet a little bit closer to each other. Lift your hips off your block and then come into a forward fold at the top of your mat. So let your head drop completely. Kind of sway a little bit side to side. Sway your back side to side. You can grab opposite elbows. You can grab your hands behind your low back and lift the knuckles up towards the ceiling, whatever feels good on your back and the neck and the shoulders. But make sure the head is completely dropped. You're just kind of draping everything. You're completely releasing your upper back. And then bring your hands to your low back and gently come all the way up to standing. Roll up one vertebrae at a time, nice and easy. As you come into your Tadasana, stand tall. Reach both arms up towards the ceiling or Bahastasana. Look up, inhale and exhale. Bring your hands to the heart center and step your left foot back behind you. As you come into this kind of a variation of Warrior One, bend your right knee. Take a nice deep breath here. And then pick up that left heel off the ground. Keep lifting the chest up. Lean your torso forward just a little bit. And then take your left elbow to the top of the right knee. So we're coming into this kind of a little bit more active. But I want you to really think about lengthening that left leg behind you, lifting that left heel. We won't stay here that long, but soften the shoulders away from the ears and just notice your body in this twist. Where do you feel this most here? Keep pressing through the bottom of that right foot. Keep breathing into your spine. Each inhalation lifts and stretches out the spine. Each exhalation rotates. One more deep breath here. Exhale. Your next inhalation, you're going to come back to the center and then step the left foot next to the right. Stand tall for just a moment. Inhale through your heart. Exhale it out. And then step the right foot back behind you. So come into your Warrior One first, plant the outside edge of the right foot, hands to your heart, and then pick up that right heel off the ground. Establish your groundedness first. So you press down to the bottom of that left foot and then lean forward, bringing your torso closer to your left thigh. Inhale. As you exhale, take your right elbow to the top of the left knee. It doesn't have to be really far, just the top of the left knee is good. Can you imagine a wall behind that right heel and you're pressing onto that imaginary wall? Your gaze can be just to the ground. It doesn't have to be up towards the ceiling unless you want to. But really breathe into your spine. Feel each inhalation lengthening the spine and each exhalation rotating the spine. Two more nice deep breaths here. Inhale and exhale. One more time. If you're tremoring a little bit, that's okay. Inhale and exhale. And then gently come back to the center. Pause for a moment here. And then step the right foot next to the left. Inhale, reach the arms up towards the ceiling or Bahastasana. Exhale, bend the knees and fold forward. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, fold, plant your hands down. Step your right foot back, left foot back, and then bring the left knees down to the floor. Inhale, lift the chest up into cow pose. Exhale, pull the belly in into cat pose. And let's do this two more times. Inhale, 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 into cow. Exhale, 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 into cat pose. And one more time, please. Inhaling. And exhale. And then take your hips all the way to your heels. And we're going to set up for a nice supported child's pose. So this is where a bolster can come in handy, or maybe you'd like to take a couple of pillows and stack them on top of one another, and then you can take more blankets and stack those on top of another. And I really like to take one of my blocks and put it under my bolster, so I've got a little bit of a structure like this, so it's kind of an incline, right? Then I take my knees wide apart from each other. My toes are touching. I'm going to inhale and then exhale. I'm going to come all the way down on top of my structure. You can turn your head to one side if you like to.
We're going to stay here for 2 minutes, 1 minute on each side. And then close your eyes. Just let yourself be supported 100% by your structure. If you don't have the block and you can, or you would like to, you can also have that structure be completely flat. So entirely up to you. I'm just giving you options. Let your arms rest next to you, or you can put your hands on top of your bolster. Just close your eyes. We're more than halfway on this side. Let the shoulders be soft once again. Feel how this, how different this supported child pose feel than the regular child pose that we often do. Now, if you'd like to turn your head to the opposite side, one more minute on this side, so close your eyes. Let the left side of your face completely rest on your bolster or structure. Breathe into your low back, breathe into the hips. Press yourself up, put your structure to the side, please. You can also put the block to the side. Come back to tabletop pose, bring your knees a little bit closer to each other so that they're hip width apart, so the knees are on train tracks, they're not together. Tuck your toes under, walk your hands all the way to your knees, and then sit on top of your knees. Inhale, reach the arms up, exhale. Take your hands behind you to your low back. As you fold forward, bring the left side of your face down onto the floor. Inhale, lift the chest once again, lift the arms up. Exhale, take your hands to your low back. Turn the right side of your face down, bring your right ear down. So that's the whole movement. Inhaling, lifting the chest up, reach up. Exhale, left side of your face comes down onto the floor. Inhale, sit tall, reach the arms up. Exhale, right side of your face comes down. And one more time, inhale, reach the left arms up. Exhale, left side of your face comes down. And inhaling, the arms up. Exhale, right side of the face comes down. Now this time, just stay here and bring the forehead down to the floor. Reach the arms to the top of your mat. Come up just a little bit so you can extend the left leg out to the left. So I'm going to turn around so you can see me. I'm on my right knee. My left leg is out to the left. And my hands are right on in tabletop pose. I'm going to reach the left arm out to the side. And then thread the left arm underneath my body as I bring my left ear down to the floor. Okay, so left leg is out, left arm is underneath the body, and my right left ear is on the floor. If this is too much and you feel like your head is dangling, now you can take your structure and put it under your left ear and let the left shoulder rest on top of your structure. Maybe some of you will just need a block. See what you need. Make sure that make sure your head is resting on something. So it's either on a block or on a structure or on the floor. Your choice. Take that left arm underneath the body. Take a nice deep breath here. Exhale it out. Inhale, If you need to, you can always put a blanket under the right knee as well. Exhale down. We're going to be here another 30 seconds. So really try and see if you can relax. And just, what is it that I'm holding on to? Maybe the shoulders, maybe the inner thighs, maybe the low back, maybe the face, maybe the jaws. Gently press your chest back up, press your torso up, bring that left knee back in, and extend the right leg out to the right. Same thing here, take that right arm out to the side, inhale. As you exhale, take the right arm underneath the body as you bring the right ear down on the floor. So your right ear can rest on the floor, it can rest on a block, it can rest on a bolster. You can rest on a bunch of blankets. Make sure your head is resting on something. I just don't want you to dangle your head like that. So make sure the head is grounded, resting on something. And then once you get there, just close your eyes and notice the sensations in the hips, in the inner thighs, in the outer thighs. We have 30 more seconds. Sensations. It's all like the sensations and breath. That's all. And then gently unwind your hands on the floor. Bring that right knee back in. Take a nice deep breath here. This time we're going to do our cat-cows a little bit different. So we're just going to wag our tail side to side. Bring the left knee to your left shoulder. Left hip to your left shoulder, right hip to the right shoulder. Just kind of wagging your hips side to side. And then tuck your toes under, lift the hips up into your downward facing dog. Bend the knees deep as you press the earth away. Just let the head hang, dangle. Let the head hangle. Let the head dangle. Completely. So heavy. The head is like so heavy. Just let it in. Breathe into the low back. Press the earth away. Keep the knees bent. Your heels can be lifted all you want. Exhale it out. Two more times. Inhale. Exhale it out loud and just let it go. Sigh it out as loud as you can. Inhale. And then walk your hands halfway up your mat and walk your feet to your hands. So you're halfway up your mat, please. Take your right leg back behind you. Bring the right ankle behind the left ankle. And for this, I like to bend both knees really deeply, especially that front knee. So bend it as much as you can. If you find that the floor is way too far, you can put your block under your hands, or you can even bring your hands to the top of your thighs, okay? So I don't want you to try and struggle to stretch out the hamstring on that right. Wherever you are, you can just drop the head down. Sometimes it also, if you're more flexible, it feels good to just rest the top of your head on a block and you just let the arms hang. So see if this is available to you. If it's not, just have your hands on top of your thighs or have your hands on a block and just relax here for just a moment. Feel that deep stretch in that right hamstring. another reason that sometimes our low back gets really tight is the transference of that tension in the hamstring. Keep breathing. Exhale it out. And then gently lift halfway up, and we're just going to switch sides. So take that right foot next to the left foot, then take the left foot behind the right. As you cross the knees, bend both knees really deeply. And again, you know, the hamstrings can be really different. Maybe you're really tight on this side. If that's the case, just come on up and hold, put your hands on top of your thighs. This should be good enough. If you can, maybe you can bring your hands down to the floor, or you can have your hands on top of your block. Or if you're a little bit more flexible, maybe your forehead or the top of your head can rest on top of the block and you just let the arms dangle. From wherever you go, let the head just completely relax. Keep both knees bent so you're not hyperextending, especially that back knee. Breathe into whatever it is that you're feeling. Whatever sensation you're feeling, it's always gonna go. It's never gonna get stuck. So let the sensation just go. Gently lift the head back up. Take that right foot next to the left foot. Roll up one vertebrae at a time, nice and slow. Keep your chin to your chest. Come all the way up to standing. Take a nice deep breath in. Reach up. Stretch it up. Interlace the fingers. Release the index finger. Bring your big toes together. Heels are an inch apart from each other. Exhale, fold to the left. Pause. Press through the bottom of that right foot. And then see if that right shoulder is folding over. Can you open the chest up and really make it about a side bend? Inhale, come back up to the center. Exhale, fold over to the right. Again, pressing through the bottom of that left foot. Roll that left shoulder open. And at the same time, make sure that right hip is not coming forward. So really keep it about a side bend. Inhale, come back up to the center. We're gonna do the same exact pose that we just did standing on the floor. So go ahead and lie down on your back. This is called Banana Asana, our final pose before our Shavasana. So lay down flat completely, bring the inside edges of your feet, your ankles together, and then take your torso over to the left, keep that right hip down on the floor. I wanted to show you before we lay down so you have a better visual, because it's probably a little hard to see as I'm laying down. Now take your left foot to the left side of your mat, so you look like a banana. Or a C. You can take your right arm overhead, grab your right wrist with your left fingertips. That right hip is gonna wanna roll up. Let the right hip stay down. We're just staying here for another 15 seconds. Breathe into that right side. This is where your liver is, so your liver is enjoying some space right now. Open into that right lung. All the muscles in between the ribs, the intercostal muscles are stretching out right now. Your diaphragm has some space to move. And then gently come back to the center, bringing your torso back in and legs back in. Pause for just a moment. And as you're ready, take your torso over to the right and then the left, the legs over to the right as well. So you look like a banana. To the right
Take your left arm overhead, grab your left wrist with your right fingertips. Let the left hip melt down on the floor, so don't let it roll up. Breathe into that left side. Your spleen lives on this side. Open into the left lung. Intercostal muscles between the left ribs are stretching out. Beautiful, beautiful stretch. And then as you're ready, just come back to the center. And we're in our final pose. So if you like to, you can take your bolster or your blankets and put it under your knees or under your head. Just get really super comfortable. Palms are open towards the sky. Close your eyes. Let the forehead be smooth. Tongue is heavy. Eyes sinking into the sockets. Feel the pulsation in your body. Feel the tingling. And the energy, the prana flowing freely in your body. This is how we create a healing environment in our bodies. Just letting go of unnecessary tension. And stepping into our own healing power. Deepen your breath. Draw one knee to your chest and then the other knee to your chest. And right here, just give yourself a big hug. Really offering yourself some loving gratitude, some loving kindness for creating this time and space to be here, to take care of yourself. What a beautiful gift to give to yourself. As you're ready, gently roll over to one side, press yourself up to a comfortable seat, bringing your hands to your heart center. The healer inside of me bows down to the healer inside all of you. Thank you so much for allowing me to guide you through your practice. Namaste.